Today, we are going to discuss the topic of regional rural banks. We have already seen that there are many types of banks which are trying to cater the need of the different sectors of the economy. The commercial banks were established with the objective to cater the poorest of poor in the economy, but they failed to achieve this objective. And that is why it was felt that the existing credit agencies, that means cooperative banks and commercial banks, they are not able to meet the demand of the rural sector with respect to agriculture and with respect to other household requirements. Similarly, the weak cooperative credit structure with respect to managerial talent, post-credit supervision and loan recovery failed to serve the objective of providing money to each and everybody who is needy and require assistance from the government. Similarly, inability to mobilize adequate resources and excessive dependence on RBI for refinance by these cooperative banks has made it very difficult for them to serve each and every person in the rural sector. And therefore, the felt need was there for some other institution. While the commercial banks, which were actually catering to the need of general public, they were having more of urban orientation. The people who were involved, the procedures which were adopted, the programs which were designed were actually catering more the need of urban setup. Similarly, when they were catering the need of urban setup, their cost of operations was comparatively high. That is why it was difficult for them to provide financial assistance at lower rate of interest. Now, regional rural banks solved all these problems, or they were an attempt to solve all these problems, because they were locally based, rural oriented and commercially organized. Now, these regional rural banks are of recent origin, because they have come into existence only in October 1975. And before 2005, there were 196 RRBs in India, which are now reduced to 56 RRBs, which is not a poor sign, rather the sign of the strength and consolidation, because the banking reforms are talking about the stronger banks. So in place of having several weak banks, we are having lesser stronger banks. Regional rural banks are set up under RRB Act 1976, which provide credit and other facilities to small farmers, agricultural laborers and artisans, among others, in the rural area. In fact, in 2015, this RRB Act was amended in such a way that these banks are able to raise capital from other sources other than the central government and state government. Though the objective still remains same, that the capital will not exceed 51%, which is the holding of the government and the sponsoring bank. A link on this particular slide of an article about in the Economic Times, also talking about the similar amendment. Some of the RRBs which you observe, which you find in your surroundings: Andhra Pradesh Grameen Vikas Bank. The sponsor is State Bank of India and it is in the state of Andhra Pradesh. I would like to highlight here that India's first regional rural bank was Prathama Bank, and the sponsor of this bank was Syndicate Bank, and it was started in Uttar Pradesh in Muradabad district. So we are having several regional rural banks which are still operating, and I would like to highlight here, though the link of that article is not available on the slide, but out of the 56 RRBs, only 2 RRBs are in losses. Remaining 54 RRBs are still making profit. That clearly shows that where is the will, there is the way. Now, the capital requirement of RRBs: in the beginning, the authorized share capital of each RRB was rupees 1 crore divided into 1 lakh shares of rupees 100 each. Now, 50% of this issued capital was subscribed to by the central government, state government and sponsoring public sector bank. The share of the central government was 50%, state government 15%, and sponsoring public sector bank was 35%. With the enactment of RRB Act 1987, which was an amendment act, the authorized capital of each RRB has been raised to rupees 5 crore and paid up capital of rupees 1 crore. The functions or businesses of RRBs. Since regional rural banks are trying to cater the requirement of rural regions, they are trying to cater the need of a particular area. The granting of loans and advances, particularly to small and marginal farmers and agricultural laborers, whether individual or in groups, and to the cooperative societies for agriculture or related purposes. And when it comes to granting of loans and advances to artisans and small entrepreneurs, they are getting the financial facilities for trade, commerce, or other industrial objectives which are requiring small financial assistance. Recent developments, if I talk about what kind of changes are taking place, already I have discussed with you that there are now 56 RRBs. Now there is a committee, Bhandari Committee, which was constituted in 1994-95. It talked about the restructuring and reviving of RRBs, because before that RRBs were just a replica of cooperative bank and they were not able to serve their purpose because of the clutches of the government and sponsoring bank. This committee has suggested amalgamation and recapitalization of large number of RRBs. In September 2005, the process started, and from 196 RRBs in 2006 to they have come down to 56. Now the link is available here on the slide, which you can easily use to check actually the name of all the 56 RRBs which are operating in our country. Now the more emphasis is also given on establishment of the branches in those districts which are unbanked, where no other bank is operating. And again, in 2013, an amendment was passed which raised the authorized capital of RRB from 50 million to 5 billion in Indian rupee, and provided that shareholders can elect the directors. That means autonomy of functioning is also being given to RRB. The result is right in front of us. As I have already said, that out of the 56 RRBs, only 2 are making losses. That means when the autonomy is given to the bank, they are able to perform better. And we can also see in the second point here, the recent development which is suggesting that more ICT intervention, that means information, communication and technology intervention should also be used by these RRBs. That means even if an RRB is located in the area which is technologically less developed, they should try to incorporate more technological based operations, more cashless operations to speed up their operation and to improve their efficiency. So these are regional rural banks.